gosh, my books just fell over.
Or should I call you
Book Pops
or Reader Pops? Please let me know in the comments down below.
Hello, Girly Pops, Book Pops, Reader Pops.
I am resurrecting my dead vlog channel to become possibly my book channel unless my hobbies change again. In that case, this will be a hobbies channel. Who knows?
I recently got obsessed with reading again. I used to be a huge reader when I was a kid. I loved dystopian series, and then I forgot that adults read books
until Lily
lent me this fine little book,
and then this whole thing started.
So no, it was not actually book talk that started this obsession, although I wouldn't be mad that reading is popular again because it supports authors,
and then authors will write more books for us, maybe, I don't know.
I'm just trying to see the positive. Some people are like, oh my gosh, reading is so popular now. I think that's great. So I'm going to share with you the 18 books that I've read since like middle of June, because when I get obsessed with something, I go full force, and I have a lot of good books to share with you guys. I'm going to fly through them all and tell you if I think you should read them or not. So like I said, the first book that I read was kindly lent to me by Miss Lily Ann. This is The Perfect Couple by Elin Hildebrand. I have not heard much about this particular book, but I've heard a lot about this author, and I have to say I loved the characters in this book. I'm a big character person when it comes to books. If I cannot have a clear picture of the characters, then I generally don't like it. Basically, they're on the island of Nantucket, which she's known for writing books in Nantucket. They have a wedding and someone dies. So it basically becomes an investigation of all of the characters at the wedding to see if she was murdered by one of them. I love books that you're just eating it so fast because you want to know the ending. And for me, the ending of this book was so anticlimactic. I was kind of pissed off, honestly. But then I reflected and I was like, but I still really enjoyed the book. It's just not the ending I would have wanted. So it's a 3 out of 5 for me. As far as my rating scale goes, if I give it a 3 out of 5, it still means I enjoyed the book. It's just not like a super memorable, crazy book I read. Beach Read by Emily Henry. This is such an iconic book cover at this point. I feel like I love book covers like this. This was recommended a lot on TikTok, and I just have to say, wow. I think I gave this a 4 out of 5 at the time, and now after reading all these other books, I actually would give this probably a 4.5 or 5 out of 5. I think I'm realizing that when it comes to romance books, I really like them if they have a really sad element to them, and this one definitely does. She is grieving the loss of her dad and the scandalous affair that her dad had. That's not a spoiler. These are spoiler free, by the way. I'm not gonna spoil anything. Sometimes I feel like explaining books makes me not interested in them, but she's a writer. She goes to this beach house next to another writer. They have a past. They're kind of enemies. They're both in a reading slump, so they decide to challenge each other and switch genres. So she's gonna try to write historical fiction and he's gonna try to write romance, and so they have to like go on dates so he can learn how to write romance books, and she has to go along with him on his research and interview cult members so that she can write the historical fiction, and it's a romance, so you know what happens. I just loved how there were very real life elements like grief and cults. So this is just gonna be a comfort read for me. I'm probably gonna reread this again. Highly recommend, you should definitely read this. Next, I bought this at a CVS when we were in Florida because I didn't know I was gonna become a reader, so I didn't know I was gonna finish this so fast. And I immediately just wanted to read another book. And this was like the only store in this town that had books. So I picked up a Nora Roberts book. This lady has written over 200 novels. Small Town Dreams. This was so forgettable, and halfway through, it starts a new story. So it's two short stories, and that pissed me off because I thought I was starting like a new chapter or continuing the story, and then it turns out to be a completely different, just, we don't need to talk about this one. 2 out of 5, don't read it. Okay, Redeeming Love by Francine Rivers. This is a Christian fiction. It's based off the book of Hosea, I believe, or?
Yeah, Hosea.
And it basically represents God's love for us. This book is so good, and I have to say my favorite part about this book, in bold, it has God's voice or the enemy's voice, and I really like how there's not a distinction. There's not like different font for the enemy versus God, because that is very similar to what it's like in your own brain. You have to do the differentiating for yourself. And so I always forget main characters' names. I'm so sorry about that. So Angel hears the enemy's voice a lot in her brain, and eventually as the story goes on, that voice starts to become quieter, and then she hears God's voice more loudly. It's just a beautiful story, and I highly, 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 highly recommend this. I believe I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. So pick this up and read it for sure. Even if you're not Christian, I think you would love this so much. All right, now we're gonna get into like the really hyped TikTok books.
It Ends With Us by Colleen Hoover.
I would check the sensitive subjects before reading this book, but I can't tell them to you because then it would spoil it.
This is my first Colleen Hoover book. She has a cult following, and so I was really, I mean, expectations were through the roof for this.
And that's kind of the problem, is when books are super hyped up, you're more critical of them. So I feel like it's not even fair. But I will say, I was gagging for the first few chapters because of how cheesy it was. That typical line of like, oh, I don't really think anyone's a bad person. We're just people who do bad things.
I don't want to be too harsh on this because so many people love it.
I loved Atlas in this book so much, and he kind of was the redeeming factor. So I loved the last 100 pages. But other than that, I think that the way she wrote about the sensitive subjects in here was super amazing, honestly. Like, it was a really great insight into how those things happen in the real world. And we can be very judgmental of those things from the outside, but this is what it is like on the inside. And so I thought that was really, really, really awesome. But like I said, check sensitive subjects before reading this. I gave this a 3 out of 5. But don't worry, I read 2 more Colleen Hoover books and she definitely redeems herself in those.
People We Meet on Vacation by Emily Henry again.
This is, I love this cover so much.
This is such a great book to read during the summer or if you're going on vacation. This really solidified that I really love Emily Henry's writing style.
In the book, Poppy is actually a travel influencer, and a lot of the things that she struggled with at the beginning, like getting your dream job and then having creative ruts, was actually really relatable to me, which I was not expecting at all.
This has the alternating timelines where they used to be friends and then they're not anymore, and you kind of are trying to figure out why, like what was the falling out the entire time.
And I really like this. I would give this a 4 out of 5, maybe 3.5 out of 5, but highly recommend. It's just fun to read.
Love Lives Here by Maria Goff. This is a Christian book. If you know Bob Goff, my favorite person ever, he wrote one of my favorite books, Love Does, and this is his wife, and the writing style is almost identical,
but I love it so much. If you don't know anything about their writing style, it's not a Christian book where they're like looking at verses and explaining them. They're just kind of applying real world scenario or using their life as a metaphor to teach you about love and kindness and patience and whimsy and whimsical lifestyles and all this sort of stuff.
And I really, 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 really loved it. She got really vulnerable in this, which I was not expecting. And I highly recommend this if you're looking for a Christian book to read that's super easy and not super technical and theological.
Well, 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 another super hyped TikTok book,
Song of Achilles
by Madeline Miller.
I had zero clue what this was going into it, but so many people said that this was a 5 out of 5 easily. It's so heartbreaking, and I don't want to be too harsh on it because the writing style was gorgeous. I will say the beginning was pretty slow for me and I was kind of confused, but at the end of the day, I do not like Greek mythology or reading about war, and that is what this is. So I'm gonna have to say this wasn't for me, but giving it a rating is not even fair because I just don't like those topics and I didn't know that that's what this book was about.
That's all I gotta say for that. I'm so sorry. Please don't kill me for that.
Okay, next. The Unhoneymooners by Christina Lauren.
Another super fun summer read. It takes place in Hawaii and it is a enemies to lovers trope.
The only thing I found interesting about this is that basically after they fall in love, they come home and it's like a whole second plot begins for another 100 pages, which was kind of confusing and different for a romance book. And I kind of liked it, but it did knock off a star for me. So I would say this is like a 3.5, although this is super loved.
So I don't know. I don't get that feeling for it that I feel like a lot of other people have,
but it was really fun to read. I just think if you're not a huge reader, I would kind of honestly pass on this one. I don't know.
Books are so personal. This is going to be so hard.
Now we're going to get into the books that I read for a full 24 hours straight. If you missed that video on my main channel, I'm really proud of it. So if you haven't seen it, go watch it. But for that video, I read 6 of Crows.
This is a fantasy novel,
a very loved
fantasy novel.
And I was really curious about this because I haven't read fantasy since I was in middle school, I believe. And so I was really curious to see if I would like it because I love dystopian and I wanted to see if this was similar. And I am still very confused on how I feel about this.
I didn't not like it, but I also didn't love it. I just feel so neutral about it. And it's very strange. Like, I bought the second book because this is a duology.
I have Crooked Kingdom and I have had no desire to start it.
And so I don't want to just say, oh, I guess I don't like fantasy because maybe it's just this.
But if you like fantasy, please recommend me something in the comments to read so that I can maybe give it another chance.
Because I feel like I would like fantasy, but I just didn't love this. So
I would give this like a 3 out of 5 stars.
I'm sorry. Oh my gosh, I just finished this the other day. The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab. This book has a lot of hype for it, and some people think that it could become a classic in the future, which I totally agree. And in saying that, you can kind of guess how it's written. The writing is beautiful and very poetic almost, but it was like pulling teeth to read the first, honestly, 300 pages. And it's like a 440 page book.
I mean, it was just dragging on for so long.
If you want to know a little bit about what this is about, it is kind of a fantasy. Addie makes a deal with the darkness and she words it incorrectly. So she's kind of cursed. So she lives forever and she's not really a human being anymore. But everyone who meets her forgets her the second they leave the room, or there's a door in between them, or they look away. They forget who she is. So that has a lot of implications, of course. It just kind of goes through like her whole 300 years of life so slowly, like such mundane details. And that's what made it so hard to read. But then at the end,
oh my gosh,
there's a plot twist and then kind of another plot twist. And that for me made it a 5 out of 5. Like that alone, the last few chapters, I was just mind blown. And then reflecting on it, I was like, maybe she made it so long and mundane because we're supposed to have the same feeling as Addie living a 300 year life, and how boring it must have been. And that's what kind of makes it so satisfying by the end of it. So I just feel like this is a good piece of literature, whether or not I was bored or not. It's just one of those books where you're like, this is objectively great writing, and the end made it so worth it for me. So if you're not really a reader, I feel like you probably won't enjoy reading this, but if you are a reader and you can stick it out, even if it's slow, definitely read this.
5 out of 5.
28 Summers by Elin Hildebrand. I borrowed this from Lily as well. I got about 250 pages in and I DNF'd it. Did not finish. This book is way too long and I don't recommend it. Next, Verity by Colleen Hoover. Actually, before I read this, I read Ugly Love by Colleen Hoover, but I gave that to Bella.
And I rated that 5 out of 5 stars.
Highly recommend. Actually had me crying at the end, which I hate when people tell me I'm gonna cry for a book because then you're just waiting to cry. But I did cry at the end of the book. And the thing is, you have to go in without expectations, because anytime someone tells me how great a book is, you're just gonna be more critical of it and your expectations are gonna be through the roof, and you're just gonna be waiting for the book to meet your expectations the entire time. And I've learned that that's how I just don't like books. Even if I really like a book, I'm gonna try to not hype it up too much because I don't want you to have that experience. But Ugly Love was a 5 out of 5 for me. And Verity by Colleen Hoover, which is actually a thriller romance. Did not know that going in. It's pretty dark, actually. It's very dark. I would check the sensitive subjects because what the heck? But wow, this was another 5 out of 5 for me. This was a book that you just can't put down because you want to see what happens. And I really, 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 really liked it. So if you want a thriller aspect to your romance, highly recommend.
A super hyped up romance book, The Hating Game by Sally Thorne.
This is such a hyped up romance book, and it's going to be a movie starring Lucy Hale, which is honestly why I wanted to read it, because I love seeing books that I read come to life, and I feel like Lucy Hale is a perfect character. But this is a enemies to lovers trope. They work side by side in cubicles. They're competing for the same job title, and yeah, I actually really enjoyed it. I don't think I enjoyed it to the point where it was like a 5 out of 5 I would get a tattoo for it, which my favorite booktuber Noelle Gallagher did, but I did really enjoy it. So I would give this like a 3 out of 5. And if you like the enemies to lovers trope, highly recommend.
Next is Malibu Rising.
Oh, by Taylor Jenkins Reid. I love the cover of this so much. And this author also wrote The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo and Daisy Jones and the Six, which are super popular books that I haven't read yet. So I think this got really hyped up just because people love this author so much. I love the aesthetic of this book. I love that it was set in Malibu. And this is interesting because I haven't read just like a contemporary fiction that doesn't have any aspects of romance in it. I mean, there's kind of some tiny romance in here, but it's basically just about this family, these siblings, their parents and their parents' parents. It switches between timelines and it's just about all the drama that ensues. And they're all really rich celebrities in this book, which also is interesting.
Yeah, I don't know how I feel about just reading contemporary fiction.
So this was enjoyable to read, but towards the end, she starts introducing so many characters, and that's kind of the part that took me out of it. I would rather just follow a single character's
or a few characters'
point of views, but then she just starts introducing celebrity after celebrity, and it's just like, okay, I don't need to see their point of view for like a chapter and then move on. You know what I mean? So that's the only thing for me. 3 out of 5. I still loved it, but wasn't like, I don't know. This won't go down in history for me. So I don't know. 3 out of 5.
I just feel bad saying 3 out of 5 because it sounds like you shouldn't read it. But if you do read it, you'll probably love it. You might love it. I don't know.
We have 2 more, guys.
2 great books left.
Love and Other Words by Christina Lauren.
Oh my gosh, I just got chills.
Remember what I said about not wanting to hype up books because I don't want you to go in with huge expectations?
I am scared to do that, but I have to say, out of all of the books here. I mean, this is top three easily. This was a 5 out of 5.
I love it
so much. I literally have chills. You can't see them. This book is a mashup between People We Meet on Vacation and It Ends With Us. If you like Lily and Atlas in this book, you need to read this book. I feel like this book was made for the Lily and Atlas fans. And then it also has the alternating timelines to when they were kids to now. And something happens when they were kids, which is why they haven't seen each other in 10 years. And the whole time you're trying to figure out what happened, which is what happens in this book. And I just love this book so much. I feel like it portrayed what your first love is like when you're in high school and you're like learning about a new human being. I just felt very, very, very realistic to me, which I love. And like I said, I kind of like when things are dark when it comes to romances. And at the end, I cried like a little baby.
Wow. I love this book so much.
Okay, guys. Lastly, The Weight of Glory by C.S. Lewis. This is out of left field. I love C.S. Lewis so much. This is not a fiction. This is a theology book, basically. This is just a collection of essays from C.S. Lewis on different relevant topics. I actually started this book in like 2019, I think. And then I picked it back up and read the last 4 chapters. Honestly, I would buy this book just to read the last 3 chapters because it was so insanely good. I love C.S. Lewis so much. His writing makes my jaw drop all the time. Wrote so many notes from this.
I hope you guys are excited that I'm making book YouTube videos. Please recommend books that I should read or what you want to see me read or what videos you want me to make on this channel. And I will see you guys on Instagram and TikTok at Hailey Fam or somewhere else on the internet.
Bye.